From the world's oldest dress to a priceless statue found in a sewer, here are 10 amazing recent discoveries. Number 10. Bruniquel Cave Chamber. Inside of the Bruniquel Cave in the southwest of France, a sort of small-scale Stonehenge but with stalagmites instead of big rocks. At first, they carbon dated the area to around 47,000 years ago, but they recently used a different kind of method. With uranium-thorium dating, sounds awesome by the way, they managed to date the area to 176,000 years ago, 3.5 times the original dating. Now, the only humans who lived there in those days were the Neanderthals, and scientists concluded that Neanderthals must have been the ones to make the stalagmite structures in the cave. This is a very important discovery because it helped scientists realize that Neanderthals were going deep down into the caves, as opposed to earlier findings. The chamber inside Bruniquel Cave gives us the opportunity to learn more about the lives of the first humans and broaden our view on our Neanderthal ancestors. Number 9. Noah's Ark Mosaic. During excavations undertaken in an ancient synagogue in Israel, Lower Galilee, scientists discovered a well-preserved mosaic depicting scenes from the Old Testament. Although the title, Noah's Ark Mosaic, makes it sound like it comes straight from the Ark itself, it actually depicts the scenes connected to Noah's journey and the Ark, hence Noah's Ark Mosaic. This mosaic contains depictions of pairs of animals, including donkeys, bears, and lions, and it was found in the ancient Jewish village of Hukok. This mosaic was found in the form of two panels, with one panel depicting a scene from Moses' parting of the Red Sea, with soldiers who are being swallowed by gigantic fish. What's really fascinating about this archaeological discovery is that it's pretty rare in its category. Experts in the field agree that there aren't many mosaics dating from that period, the 5th century AD, which depict these kinds of scenes. In fact, there are only two known synagogues which contain such mosaics. One is present-day Syria, which depicts a different scene, and the other is in Israel, which is pretty fragmented and not very well preserved. All of this makes the newly found mosaic a one-of-a-kind discovery. Who knows, maybe there will be more of them to come. And now for number 8, but first, be sure to subscribe! New videos are posted 4 days a week. Number 8. A Russian Doll Pyramid. Russia and the pyramids? How does this make any sense? Well, it will soon. The Kukulkan Pyramid, located in the state of Yucatan in present-day Mexico, offers much more than the eye can tell. It is not only one pyramid, but, wait for it, 3 pyramids. One inside of another, inside of another, inside of another. This is why many refer to it as the Russian doll among fellow pyramids, as it resembles the one inside of another concept of the famous Matryoshka dolls. While researching, scientists used a very useful method called electrical resistivity, during which they passed electrical waves through the pyramidal structure and measured the degree of resistivity. The results were nothing short of amazing. It turned out that the Kukulkan Pyramid, also known as El Castillo or the Castle, had 2 more pyramids inside of it. The scientists found out that the 2 smaller pyramids were built much earlier, which means that the whole 3-level structure wasn't built at the same time, but over a course of several centuries. The smallest was built around 550 AD, the middle one 3 centuries later, and the outermost one somewhere in the 12th or 13th century. It seems that the Maya people can still pull a surprise on us. Kudos to them! Number 7. The Antikythera Man. One of the largest sea wrecks of the ancient world is probably the Antikythera shipwreck, which happened around 65 BC. It was discovered in 1900 off the coast of the island of the same name. The find was truly a wonderful one, as there were many different items from the ancient times, including bronze statues, a lot of treasure, and probably the most important item of all, the Antikythera mechanism, widely considered as the world's first computer. But recently, a big international team comprised of many scientists discovered something new in the Antikythera wreck, a skeleton of a man. There have been other human remains located in the area of the wreck, but this is the first find in almost half a century, and it's the first one in the age of DNA analysis, which is in itself amazing. Findings of this kind happen very rarely, and scientists are dead excited to have the opportunity to examine the genetics of ancient people. The Antikythera Man will give scientists the opportunity to go deeper into the lives of the ancient population and possibly discover something even more fascinating. Number 6. Akkadian City in Iraq. In present-day Iraq, a large group of international archaeologists found the remains of a big city that most probably belonged to the Akkadian Empire, which is one of the civilizations that flourished in the region of ancient Mesopotamia. This ancient city was founded more than 4,500 years ago, and it lasted for over one millennium. On the site, scientists also discovered tablets with a cuneiform scripture, which is one of the first known writing systems in the ancient world. This means that the newly found Akkadian city was also a major cultural center. The site of the find is in the Kurdish region, also known as the Kurdish Iraq, near the village of Basetki. Scientists agree that this region holds a lot of archaeological locations that are still waiting to be excavated. This region was a crossover area of many cultures in the ancient times, and many cultural traditions of the time overlapped here. Thus, this city is probably just a tip of the iceberg when it comes to archaeological finds. There will most likely be a lot more of them in the years to come. Hopefully. Number 5. The burial boat in Abydos. Burial boats were a normal custom in ancient Egypt, as many pharaohs were buried this way. The whole idea behind a burial boat is to have a resting place for the pharaoh before reaching the undying lands, to borrow a Lord of the Rings reference. On the desert site of Abydos, archaeologists found the location of a burial boat belonging to the pharaoh Senwosret III. If you don't know who that is, don't worry. Here is what remains of a statue of his face. Fun fact, according to the Metropolitan Museum of Art, the face of Senwosret III is one of the most individual and recognizable in all of Egyptian art. But back to the boat. Not much remained of the original boat, only some planks. However, what is almost intact is a big burial chamber, 21 meters long by 4 meters wide, with more than 120 drawings of boats. And this is just the beginning, as scientists hope to find even more drawings similar to these. It's pretty amazing that these drawings were even discovered in a well-preserved state, considering that the actual tomb dates back to 1850 BC. This is one of the most important findings of its kind. Number 4. Stilt houses of East Anglia. Britain is often overlooked when discussing archaeological findings, but the region is fascinatingly rich in all kinds of ancient locations and archaeological sites. One of those is a recently discovered dwelling dating back to the Bronze Age. What's even more amazing is that this is the most well-preserved find of its kind. In eastern England, in the area known as the Fens or the Fenlands, archaeologists found a well-preserved dwelling from 3,000 years ago, around the end of the Bronze Age. The settlement was built of houses on stilts, and they probably got destroyed by fire collapsing into the river. This actually preserved the whole dwelling because it was plunged into the river and thus kept virtually intact. The whole site is located 2 meters below the ground, and it's a real time capsule. There are a lot of everyday items, such as jars and bowls, that give scientists a great deal of information on what it was like back in the day. The area is so well preserved that there are even footprints found of the people who inhabited the place. A truly wonderful find. Number 3. The Tarkhan Dress. It's pretty rare to find a well-preserved piece of clothing from ancient times. The main reason for this is that cloth usually wears out quite quickly, as it succumbs to atmospheric changes faster than wood or rock. However, the so-called Tarkhan dress, named after the Egyptian town where it was discovered back in 1923, is one of those rare artifacts. Although it was originally discovered in 1913, scientists couldn't really date it with accuracy. It was obvious that the dress was from ancient Egypt, but it was unclear when exactly it was worn. Scientists have managed to find out the exact time this piece of cloth was used, and it dates between 3482 and 3103 BC. This means that the Tarkhan dress is the oldest piece of clothing found ever. It's really fascinating that we have the opportunity to see what people wore in those days, and judging by the look of this dress, it would probably be all the rage today. Number 2. London Roman Tablets. Back to Britain. During excavations for a building site, archaeologists discovered wooden tablets from the Roman era, all of which contain amazing information about everyday life in ancient Londinium. Yep, that's the real Roman name of the place. From these writings, we can now learn more about all kinds of transactions and events that took place, including the names of people who participated in the events during these times. The tablets are a fascinating find not only because of the information they hold, but also because of the way they're constructed. They are a great example of a once popular writing technique in Roman times, etching letters onto a waxed plank using a pointed stylus. These kinds of wooden tablets rarely survive to the modern times, but just like the stilt houses in East Anglia, a river got in the way and saved them. Another amazing fact is that in most cases, the writings on the wax don't survive, but sometimes a scribe presses down too hard, leaving marks on the wood beneath the wax. Because of this, we can now learn more about what it was like to live in Roman London. Number 1. Statue of Pharaoh Ramses II. In the groundwater of a Cairo slum, archaeologists have found a 26-foot statue of what is most likely Pharaoh Ramses II, who ruled Egypt around 3,000 years ago. According to most archaeologists, this statue is probably one of the most important findings ever. The mere size of it sends shivers down your spine. It's colossal in every sense of the word. The statue was discovered near the ruins of a temple dedicated to Ramses II in the eastern part of Cairo, the area which was once the ancient city of Heliopolis. What's even more fascinating is that this isn't just any old pharaoh. Ramses II was one of the most powerful rulers ancient Egypt ever had, and he was also widely celebrated. He expanded the empire and reigned more than 60 years. When it comes to pharaohs, it doesn't get much better than this. Who knows what other wonders lay hidden beneath Egypt's surface? So far, the statue of Ramses II is definitely high on the list of the most amazing recent finds. Which one of these discoveries surprised you the most? Let us know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye!